It's the NFL on EA Sports, where we'll see teams who have been division rivals since 1961. It's the Minnesota Vikings and the Philadelphia Eagles, and it's coming up next.
Just north of the Delaware Expressway and east of Broad Street, we find ourselves at Lincoln Financial Field in South Philly. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Minnesota Vikings and the Philadelphia Eagles. And hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking, tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that can have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
The Florida Atlantic man, Greg Joseph, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. Now, for the first time, we get to see this Philadelphia offense led out by their dual-threat quarterback now in his third season, Jalen Hurts.
Jalen Hurts got the green light as a starter from the Philly organization and took really good steps as the next in line of mobile quarterbacks in the city, following names like Michael Vick, Donovan McNabb, and Randall Cunningham. He led the team in all quarterbacks in the NFL in rushing, and he took Philadelphia to the postseason while throwing for over 3,000 yards.
Hurts with a little pop pass on the jet sweep. And he'll hope that this is not a sign of what's in store as he has to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. Again, that's Watkins. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
Hurts. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
No surprise they decided to throw on third down. A little bit of a surprise that they completed the pass and lost yardage on the play.
Here's Aaron Sipos out now to punt on fourth down. Fair catch called for and made at about the 32-yard line.
The Vikings offense coming out for the first time and in his fifth season leading this crew, coming off his third career Pro Bowl nod, Kirk Cousins.
Kirk Cousins is back for his fifth year as Minnesota starter, tied for the longest streak of stability the team has had at quarterback since. Get this, Fran Tarkenton in the late 1970s. He's been excellent during that time, making a second Pro Bowl last season after 4,200 yards and 33 touchdowns through the air. The Vikings, though, still hovering right around 500 at the 8-win mark, hoping to see him lead a talented roster back to the postseason.
give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
They run again on first down, Cook. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there on second down.
Well, in every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Cousins now from the 50. They're looking for Jefferson, but this is intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury. And the Eagles are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line.
Now, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball. And I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
So back onto the field, here come the Eagles for their second drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And a good push there defensively as they stop him at the 48. Gain of just 1.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The run only got 1 yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Here's Hurts to throw. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And some room to roam now. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. He'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
And only able to muster a couple, down to about the 27.
Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Got a man. It's Brown.
And he is going to have an Eagles first down as this defense unable to hold. It's a 7-yard gain there on 3rd and 2.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
On 1st and 10, it's Sanders.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Second down, back to Sanders.
This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
And on third and five, this will be the 8th play of the drive.
Throwing is Hurts.
He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
That's a sharp throw right there on third down. They're looking to get the first points of the game, and they certainly don't want to be on a field goal. So that's a nice job to get the hookup and set up a first and goal.
First and goal from just inside the 5. They'll run with Sanders, and he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. We're scoreless after 1.
Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they come up now second and goal. A carry here for the big tight end, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Grant Calcaterra taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Eagles post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter.
Well, we had the scoreless first quarter of play. We sure didn't have to wait long into the second quarter to get some action on the scoreboard.
So was the first quarter a feeling out process? I mean, that was an interesting quarter, wasn't it? Because we had some action, we had some good play, just didn't have any points. So now it's game on.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. He's got it, and the Eagles lead it 7-0.
The 10-play drive that time, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25.
The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number 2?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others. Where they think they have an advantage, dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
KJ Osborne with the first down grab in the Minnesota Vikings organization. They're all eager to see exactly what they have in him because he came out of nowhere in 2021 with 50 catches and 7 touchdowns after not catching a pass as a rookie in 2020. He certainly earned a chance to be in the team's top 3, and they want to see if he can build on those numbers from 2021.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And this one not going anywhere.
They give it the 44 for a gain of just 1 yard.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's 2nd and 9, just 1 yard on that last run. Play fake, Cousins. Throw left side, complete. That's Smith. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. Cousins gives way to Cook.
And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. It's second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. Throwing is Cousins. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Cousins to throw it. That's complete to Justin Jefferson. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 34-yard line. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
But whenever you call and run the hitch route, a lot of times that ball's got to be in the air before the receiver even turns around. That's the result of throwing it so many times in practice. It's really a timing route. Make sure that ball's out of your hands, and oftentimes the receiver turns around, and there's the ball. Nice completion there.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Cousins. And this one right back into the hands of Jefferson. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. They'll try the middle with Cook. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Although his reputation as a speedy runner precedes him, it's always fun to watch him work.
It is eye-opening, isn't it? Because when you see him get the ball and just go, in addition to that speed, it helps out his blockers. They don't have to hold blocks for long because he's just going to speed right past them.
And they've got three tight ends here on first and goal to add some extra mass. On the jet sweep, here comes Jefferson. Showed off the footwork, but still corralled shy of the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there, all 11 guys on defense, diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. Now Cousins. The quick slant caught. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. Only 3 yards there on the completion. That'll lead to a third and goal.
When you run a drag route like this down near the goal line, you're hoping maybe you get an inadvertent pick to set your man free. A lot of people call them natural screens, but this was well defense, and they stopped him for just a short gain.
Third and goal for Cousins. And it's caught. Able to hold him to just 2 yards, and now it's fourth and goal.
A short gain that doesn't get him the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
They'll run for it. Cook. And he'll wind up being knocked back to the 3-yard line. Cook turned away on fourth and goal. And this Eagle defense stands tall down near the goal line. A chance to get some momentum here in the second quarter, getting their first trip into the red zone, but unable to get it across.
And if I'm the head coach, sure, you feel some disappointment, maybe a little bit of deflation there because you didn't get it in, but I'm going straight to rah-rah mode. All right, guys, we didn't get it this time. It's only the second quarter. We'll be back. Let's get it later on. I want to keep this team up. I don't want them to feel like they've let everyone down.
Positive.
Got to be positive in this situation. It's too early to think that you don't have a chance to win this game.
And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a game.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Second and 5 now. Hurts over the middle. He's got Watkins. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
He'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right, and he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a halt. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
I certainly like what he did right there because he smartly wanted to avoid forcing anything downfield because nothing appeared to be open. Nice harmless slide there to avoid the big hit, and he gets a small gain on the play.
Now a second down and 6.
They'll look to throw here. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Sanders has it over the middle. And he's going to have a first down, and they get into field goal range here at the 29. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So it's 3rd and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
How about this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive? They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and press your advantage.
Here's Aaron Sipos now.
A punt of 46, a return of 5.
And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half.
They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground.
And an anxious moment or two there, but they do get him down.
And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Final play of the half, Cousins. And that is incomplete. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard.
As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, let's run through the next-gen stats for the Vikings in that first half. And I can imagine the halftime discussions are about how can we improve the running game. They have not had success so far, and it's reflected on the scoreboard. Meanwhile, for the Eagles, you get a look at what they were able to do throwing the football. And whatever they've done, it's worked, as they have the lead through two quarters of play.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. The Vikings set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail it here as we resume play. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line.
Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third.
And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
Just work with me a second here, because in my lifetime, seeing how quarterback percentages have changed in throwing the football, I mean, back in the good old days, if you were around 50%, you were doing okay, but now you need to be 65 to 70% to be considered an elite quarterback. And in this ball game, I feel like we're playing old school, right around 50%.
Yeah, he's under 50%. He needs to start hitting more targets.
Well, after incompletions on first and second down, it certainly seems like a reflection of what we've seen so far in this game. The defense, quicker to the punch so far. Let's see if they can get something going here on third down.
On third down, Cousins.
Oh, going for Jefferson downfield.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, this is just a continuation of what we saw in the first half. So much for the fresh start to begin the third quarter. Still off target throws, no rhythm throwing the football, and obviously no touchdown scored in this game.
The Vikings send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. They start on the ground here at Sanders. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
From the 38, Hurts. That swung out wide to Sanders. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5. And now 1 yard to go on third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
First and 10, it's Hurts. Over the middle here to Brown. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. From just shy of midfield, Hurts. And Sanders has got it, complete. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
On third and short, they'll try option left. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. So that was all you're looking for on a play like that. Get the first down and keep the drive moving.
Yeah, it just looked to me like he just said to himself, I've got this. I'll take it. I'll pick it up and let's keep moving. Get the first down, get a new set, and let's start over.
Hurts a handoff to Sanders. Fast footwork by Sanders. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard.
But first down, Hurts. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. A well-designed corner blitz that gets him for a loss of 8 yards.
Hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again?
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run-blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Hurts. Open man downfield is Sanders. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Miles Sanders,
38 yards. And the Eagles go up by two touchdowns.
Circle that drive, because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Elliott now to add the extra point.
And it's good to make it 14-0.
A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all. And it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25.
Minnesota's offense takes over possession. They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit, 14-0 the score as they regroup with first and 10. They start the drive with Cook. 51 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. Here's Cook again. They juked him. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 17 yards, first down, Vikings.
Well, that is a running back who was not about to go down easily. He fought his way through the contact until the seas opened up for him.
And that, in a nutshell, shows you what this guy's made of. I mean, most guys in the NFL just can't do that. He absorbed the contact, refocused himself, and made a break for the end zone.
And the next-gen stats shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another 1st and 10. Here's Cousins. Middle of the field to Jefferson. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Coming up on a 2nd and 6. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he's going to take this close to the first down marker as he stopped at the Eagles 42.
It's a 5-yard gain, but they'll still be a yard short here with 3rd down now looming.
Not a ton of room available on that one, but he made use of what space was available and gained decent yardage.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Now we've got movement up front, and I think this is going to be on Minnesota.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
Well, that's a tough, costly penalty, because now it makes it 3rd and 6 after the false start. Cook following the penalty. And he'll be stopped well short. Only 2 yards there, 4th and 3.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this 3rd down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
And a fake here, direct snap to the up man. Before they can get the punt away, whistles as we've come to the end of the 3rd quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
Well,
there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe it's...
As Sanders has it poked free, and the Vikings pick up the football. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game, so hold on here, not done in the fourth. And the Vikings now heading onto the field. They trail by two scores in the fourth, and their defense did its job getting the fumble recovery. And time to see what this offense has left in the tank. A Cook running on first down, but this defense up to the task there as they stop him before he can even get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it a loss of one officially.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. To throw, Cousins. And his throw's going to be incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with a short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
The offense on third down tonight, they've only converted once in four tries. This is third and 11. To throw is Cousins. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
You can tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it up to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
Desperation time. Cousins on fourth down. Going for the deep ball. He's got his man. It's taken in for a Viking touchdown. KJ Osborne, 51 yards. And the Vikings are finally on the board here in the fourth quarter. When you're trailing in the fourth quarter, you got to take some chances you might not normally take. And here, that one pays off big time.
And you have to think to yourself, not only did that pay off big time for them, but what was going on the opposite side of the ball? They know that they have to take a chance here. They know they have to come up with something big, yet it still happens. So credit the execution, but wonder what the defense was doing.
Joseph connects on the extra point. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. Now, Charles, of course, you got to remember, last possession they fumbled, it led to a touchdown. One-score game here, got to be careful.
And this is where coaching and training really comes into play, doesn't it? What does everyone say after an error? Next play, move on, next drive. That mantra has to come to the front. They've got to take care of business right here and act like the last series just didn't happen.
Tackle made there by Jordan Hicks. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And this, and he lost the football, and the Vikings pick up the football. And he brings it back to right around the 26-yard line.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets tested a little bit, because I know the defensive guys were over there chilling on the sidelines, and all of a sudden, they heard the sudden change call, because that fumble puts them right back on the field, and they've got to go out and finish the game now themselves.
Absolutely. Nursing that slim lead here in the fourth, a costly turnover.
Cook up the gut.
It was T.J. Edwards who brought him down.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
From the 22, Cousins. He's got Smith here.
And they're going to get this down inside the 20.
I know sometimes we can get fooled when we watch him make catches, as we just saw him do there, because he really looks like a wide receiver the way he goes about his business.
Yeah, 230, 240 range.
Yeah, not super huge. Maybe not counted on to be that inline point of attack blocker that we used to have in the good old days, but you can flex him out. You can run wide receiver routes with him. You can make him a primary target, and that's how he'll shred a defense.
Cousins on third and two. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. Javon Hargrave, the D tackle, getting the sack.
Javon Hargrave's second year in Philadelphia, brought the returns the Eagles were hoping for. Made his first Pro Bowl with 7.5 sacks and really meshed well with the other pass rushers along the team's front line.
A little extra pressure with this one for Greg Joseph.
This from 42 yards out.
Joseph's got it. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10.
So kind of disappointing there. I mean, yes, they get the 3, but with starting field position like that, 3's not what you're banking on.
No, and you just have to wonder if you can afford to let chances like that continue to pass you by. You've got to find ways to get the ball to the end zone and put 6s on the scoreboard.
Joseph now to kick this one away.
And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football. And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already.
Throwing is Hurts.
Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
Well, hang on now. We're going to pause here. We've got an injured player. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. Kevin O'Connell clearly unhappy with that call, and he's thrown that red challenge flag out on the field. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So score one for Kevin O'Connell. His decision to throw the challenge flag, a good one.
Throwing again on second down. Hurts escaping the pressure right. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down.
Well, it certainly appears to me that the defensive guys are starting to look a little bit tired while he still has some fresh legs. Not the biggest gain we've seen on a scramble, but still some positive yardage on a play that initially looked like a sure win for the defense.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
And this is caught by Watkins. And they get him down about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A third down pickup of five. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up four.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down to close to the goal line at the 1 yard line.
The field position game often so overlooked, but this offense is going to be backed up deep. What an ideal punt.
And now, this stage of the game, when they need the drive to try and put themselves in a position to win it, you talk about going the long field, the very long field. This could be a 99-yard drive if they're able to accomplish it.
Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Well, he got what he could there, just trying to move forward and gain a little bit of yardage and create some space. You know the pressure is going to be tough defensively.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. They run it again with Cook. Able to bust through the tackle, but not much to show for it. Still inside the five. They follow up the gain of two with a gain of one that time. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going.
Completes this to Jefferson.
That he won't quite make it. He needed six. He got about five. Fourth down.
They got the completion. Now, they probably had two plays called in the huddle, so they've got to get to the line of scrimmage, get set, and run their fourth down play.
The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he is going to pick up the Vikings' first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive.
Just a gain of three, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. One crisis averted, but they still need to move hastily.
Now Cousins. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted.
Darius Slay with a pick.
When you talk about making winning plays, that is a winning play at this stage of the game. To come up with that interception, huge.
I like how you identified that because most people think winning plays are the offense trying to get it done. In this case, nursing a lead. They found a way to make a play on that side of the ball and maybe finish things off.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession.
And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. Sanders here as they run out of the gun, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with 65 seconds remaining. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. Once again with Sanders, and he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game.
It's one play at a time. Yeah.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Hurts. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the five at the six. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Now, there certainly was a lot going on that play. Every option in the end zone, covered. No place to go with the ball. Had to swing it out to the back. A good job running and getting him tackled in the open field.
The kick by Elliott is good, and the drive will wind up yielding three. Well, from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
One last shot now for Cousins. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner. Although on that last play, they were so backed up, it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.